Hello everyone, welcome to my MechTech channel where I mainly discuss on the technical topics mainly from mechanical background. Today's my discussion topic is the extract from IJMA standard for piping stress analysis. IJMA standard is mainly for expansion joint manufacturing, and this is one association of expansion joint manufacturers. So in this presentation I will give a brief about the expansion joints, and I will tell you about means I have extracted some points from this IJMA standard for piping stress analysis purpose. Also I have given idea about the expansion joints where we are using in this expansion joint in the piping systems. So first topic in this presentation is what is the expansion joint, or we will discuss about what is about the expansion joint. As you know that this is a IJMA standard is for mainly metallic expansion joints, and this expansion joint is flexible element which is intended to use in piping system to absorb expansion or contraction or deflection or bending or torsional in piping systems. In that way we can protect the piping system from the various movements. Normally expansion joints are bellows used at piping connection to equipment, mainly rotating equipments like pumps, compressor, turbines. Bellow absorbs piping movements and safeguards piping and equipments from excessive loads. So mainly you observe that when the piping system is connected to any rotating equipments, there you find the major piping movements, or you find the major vibrations near to that rotating equipment. So there is a need to install expansion joint to minimize the piping movements and safeguard the piping and equipment from the excessive load. For that purpose we use the expansion joints. This IJMA standard guides to locate the anchor supports and their spacing. In this IJMA standards, where to locate the anchors for the piping system, or where to locate the supports and the spacing between this, mean distance between the two supports or two anchors, it is given, or which item to be considered as a anchor, that guidelines is given in the IJMA standards. This type of bellows to be used also it is given in the this standards, means for which movement which type of expansion joint or bellow we have to use. In this standard they have provided numerous examples of determining the location and type of expansion joint most suitable for the application, means according to application which type of this bellow to be used, that is this guidelines is given in the this IJMA standard. So this pipe anchor purpose is to divide the pipeline into individual expanding sections. Since we in piping system we will find that thermal growth because of the temperature inside the fluid and other parameters. So this thermal growth cannot be restrained. It then becomes a function of pipe anchors to limit and control the amount of movement which expansion joint located between these anchors must absorb. Major pieces of connected equipment such as turbine pumps, compressor, heat exchangers, reactors may function as anchor. IJMA standards explains about the calculation of load on main anchors. In this standards, how much load coming on the anchors, main anchor or intermediate anchors, that how to calculate that loads, that formulas and guidelines given in this standard. So we came to know that how much load is coming on that particular angle, and also for intermediate anchor application involving straight pipe section only, involving branch line, involving lateral deflection and angular rotation, how much load is coming, that formulas are given in the ESMA standards that we can refer and calculate that loads, so that we can find out whether that loads are allowable or not, that guidelines given in the ESMA standards. So this expansion joints or bellows we can use in service condition pressure range from full vacuum to 68.9 bar and the temperature range from minus 215 degrees Celsius to 982 degrees Celsius. This metallic expansion joint we can use in between this pressure and temperature range. So next topic of discussion is the dimension of bellows and pressure stresses on the bellows. So how the expansion joint is manufactured and what are the dimensions of that bellows, that is covered in the in this topic. So bellow mainly constructed from the thin stainless steel sheet. That sheet thickness is from 0.2 mm to 1 mm and depending on the applications we can use the convolutions of single ply, double ply or triple ply depending on pressure and application. Thickness also we can select from application whether it is required to take more load, then we have to take more thickness. And for convolutions also single ply means one single bellow is constructed. If we put one on a bellow, same construction we put on that bellow, it is a double ply, like that triple ply, depending on pressure application we can use that bellows. This bellow convolutions acts as like a spring to absorb or to take the loads. So this pressure thrust is equal to pressure into cross-sectional area of the mean. So it develops at the elbows in the piping system. Next point is the pressure stresses. The ability of bellow to carry pressure is limited by hoop stress S2 that runs circumferentially around the bellows due to pressure difference between the inside and the outside of the bellows. This mainly hoop stress is runs circumferentially and the bellows means the pressure is acted on that bellow is due to the internal and external. The bellow ability to carry pressure is also limited by bulge stress S4 that runs longitudinal to the bellow center line. More specifically, it is located in the bellow sidewall and it is measure of tendency of the convolution to become less U-shaped and more spherical. In this slide, we will see the dimension of bellow. These dimensions are mainly this thickness of this bellow, then number of convolutions in the bellows, number of bellows material plies, means single ply, double ply, that we can see the bellow tangent length, bellow convoluted length, bellow material thickness at tangent, convolution height, inside diameter of convolution root, in outside diameter of convolution crest. These are the dimensions we require for calculating the loads as per this ESMA standards, and for this manufacturing purpose also we need these dimensions. Next point of discussion is the bellow movements. This is the most important point in this bellows. This ESMA standards are only intended for application to metallic bellow expansion joints. Metal bellows are convoluted steel thin wall sheet tube that I have already told. There are five movements in the bellows: axial movement, angular movement, lateral movement, like that. Some square is there and torsional movement is there. So first we'll discuss about the axial movement. In this figure you can see the axial and lateral and angular movement diagram I have shown. So this convolutions evenly compress and it is limited as the convolution start touching each other It results to stress concentration and will be cause of early failure. Same way, expansion of convolutions also limited to avoid failure. This axial movement is mainly in one direction, and that convolutions acts like a spring, and when it is this compression and expansion is the axial movement, the bellows in one direction. So the care to be taken that convolution should not touch to each other. Then if it touches, then it will fail. Like that expansion also, it should not be expanded more than its limits. Next movement is the angular movement. This angular movement of bellows should be limited up to 5 degrees. Maximum we can go up to the 10 degrees, but beyond that, if you go, then it will act as a bellows, and it will act as an elbow. It will not act as a bellow because it will not take angular movements if we go beyond the 10 degree movement. Next movement is the lateral movement. In this movement, shearing of convolutions happens, hence it has to be limited. This shearing of the bellow is happening in lateral movement. The next movement is the squirm. Bellow, when we give the pressure from inside during the hydro testing or during the operation, the bellows eventually buckle or squirm at internal pressure loading. So that design the bellows to avoid squirm during operation and pressure testing. The next movement is the torsional movement. Twisting of metal bellows is a torsional movement. That is, when bellows we weld it with the pipe, it is done by the GTAW welding, and the thickness of the bellow means, as you in earlier side I have mentioned, that it is a 0.2 to 1 mm. That is means it is very less thickness. When we weld with the GTAW process, that is the process we can weld the bellows with the pipes. So that strength of for this torsional movement is less. So it is not recommended to use bellows for the torsional movement. The next point of discussion is material of the bellow and various causes of bellow failures. So selection of material of bellow is depend on the application where it is used and the inside media of that bellow. Based on that, we can select stainless steel material and the nickel alloy materials. In stainless steel category, we can use the material grade of 304, 316, 321. Like that we can use. And for nickel alloys, where the high temperature media will be there or corrosive media is there, then we can use the nickel alloy materials. And this nickel alloys we can use as a Monel 400, Inconel 600, Inconel 800, Inconel 825, like that Histolyte C276 we can use. So these are the main materials in the industries we can use for the manufacture of bellow. Then the various causes of bellow failures, we found that these bellows during the operation fails due to the first is the stress corrosion cracking, then carbide precipitations, twisting and rupture, fatigue, chlorides, caustic gas contents, unstabilizer material at high temperatures, overpressure due to vibration, due to shipping and handling damages, due to improper installation and insufficient protection. These are the factors due to which the bellows are failing during the service. And also there is one more factor, that is improper anchoring, guiding, supporting of piping system. Means if we do improper supporting or anchoring in the piping system, then there is also chance of bellow failures. During the service, if anchor fails, then also the bellow will fail because the total load will be distributed on that anchors, so that the bellow also fail, because when while installation or while locating the bellows, we also consider the anchor locations. Then we will see the next point is the types of expansion joints. In this, the first type is the single untied bellow. These single untied bellows are used for low pressure application and axial pressure thrust when it is very less. Then we can use single untied bellow. Then universal untied bellow, next type of expansion joint, that we can use these bellows for low pressure. This can also this universal untied bellows can take axial moments and lateral deflections also. And third type of expansion joint is the tied single bellow that will take less amount of lateral movement. Tied means this bellow, the tie rod is connected on that this bellow, so that it is called tied bellow, and it is nut, it is welded with the nut and bolt arrangement so that we can adjust the movement of the bellows. Then similar way, tied universal bellow is there, the next type of expansion joint. These are the figures of tied single bellow and tied universal bellow. The next type of expansion joint is a hinged bellow. When two sets of hinges, as shown in the figure, they can take the angular and lateral movements in one plane. So no pressure thrust is transmitted to the piping system. We use this hinge type of bellows. Similar way, gimbal bellows are there, the next type of expansion joint, where the four set of hinges are used on this bellow convolutions. So they can take angular and lateral movements in any plane, and no pressure thrust transmitted to the piping systems. This is the figure of the universal gimbal bellow. And next type of expansion joint is the pressure balance expansion joints. This is mainly used where pressure loading is excessive and objectionable. They can accept axial, lateral and limited angular movements. So you know, in this figure 2.17, this figure is taken from the ESMA standard. So this shows a typical application of pressure balance expansion joint for combined axial movement and lateral deflection. Both the anchors at the end of piping run and that on the turbine are intermediate anchor, and only directional guiding is required as shown in figure G. By proper design, the guide directly above the turbine can be made to absorb the axial movement force of the expansion joint without imposing these on the turbine. The only force imposed on the turbine is that which is required to deflect the expansion joint laterally. The next point is the selection and application of the expansion joints. So the first step of selection of expansion joint is to choose tentative location for pipe anchors, which depends on piping configurations, availability of structural members suitable for use as anchors, location of pipe fittings, static equipment, rotary equipment can be considered as an anchor. So this this is the first step to select the bellows, bellow location, and where means where to locate the bellows. That is the criteria. That means you have to tentative locate the pipe anchors, or you have to study the structural members already present in that piping systems, or where are the location of the pipe fittings like elbow walls, or where are there, and any static equipment or rotary equipment can be there in the piping system, so that we can consider that rotating of static equipment as an anchor, and we can place near to that one intermediate anchor, and we can make that one system, and in between that we can install this expansion joint. So this is the first step of selection, expansion joint. And the final decision on anchor location and the type of expansion joints to be used can only be made after a comparison of various alternative solutions. cost of this expansion joint, ability to comply with the cyclic life, because this expansion joint number of cycles, how many cycles it can take, and force requirements, space restrictions, these are the factors we have to taken into consideration for taking the final decisions for location of and selection of the expansion joint. The selection and proper application of expansion joints for lateral deflection, angular rotation, and combined moment involves the evolution of number of variables. These can include the piping configuration, the operating conditions, desired cycle life, load limitation upon piping components, equipments, and available supporting structure. Two or more types of expansion joints may be suitable for particular applications. We can use two or more type of expansion joint in one system, so that it is depends on the how much load is coming on that system, how many movements are there, and how much vibrations are there in that system. Accordingly, we can select two or more expansion joints or bellows in that system. So here I have given one selection for axial moment, selection of bellow for axial moment from the ESMA standard. This figure is 2.2. In this figure, you can see there are two main anchors at the bellows, at the elbows, and in between two anchors there is one intermediate anchor, and near to that both sides the bellows are located and installed. So in this figure, that is the it is a good practice in the use of double expansion joint to absorb axial pipeline expansion. Note the addition of the intermediate anchor, which is in conjunction with the two main anchors, divide the pipeline into individual expanding sections, so that there is only one expansion joint between any two anchors. That is our main purpose, that we can install the one expansion joint between two anchors. Note also the closeness of the first guide, that is G1 alignment guide, to each expansion joint. The spacing between the first alignment guide and the second alignment, that is G1 to G2, and the spacing of the intermediate guides G along the balance of the each pipeline section. For that, the ESMA has given the distance of the G1 from the this elbow, distance of the G2 from this elbow, how much distance should be kept for this guide. That guidelines is given in the ESMA standards. We can calculate that distance from this formula. Maximum intermediate guide spacing for any pipe material or thickness shall be calculated using this formula. In this formula, we have to use plus and minus sign according to when the bellow is compressed in operation, use positive, and when extended, use negative. So this figure 2.3 also given for this minimum guide spacing requirement, that is the distance of G1 is given as the 4 times the diameter of the pipe. So the recommendations given for the pipe anchor and the guides represents the minimum requirement for controlling pipelines which contains expansion joints and are intended to protect the expansion joint and pipe system from abuse and failures. However, addition of pipe supports are often required between the pipe guides in accordance with the accepted piping practice. This figure also we can refer for locating the this one distance of the guides. In y-axis you can see the intermediate guide spacing in feet, and on x-axis you will see the according to the pressure, means maximum pressure in psig, and this horizontal lines lines are for the size of the pipes, 3 inch, 4 inch, 5 inch, like that. The pipe size are given accordingly. We can locate or we can find out the distance between the guides. So next topic of discussion, the bellow design aspects. We can see here not full design of the bellow, only some points were related to the piping stress analysis we will see from this HMA standards. This metal bellows can be used where in application where the vibration is of high frequency and low amplitude. The HMA standard gives criteria for determining the need for internal sleeves and design recommendation for internal sleeves and also for external cover. When you see the expansion joints with the sleeve, there are inside the sleeve is welded also to cover the convolutions. The cover is provided on the convolutions. So you will see the pipe like structure is like pipe of that bellow. So this criteria for determining the need of internal sleeves and the design recommendation of internal sleeves is given in this HMA standards. Also cover requirement is also explained in this HMA standard. The analysis normally are based on assumptions which approximately predict the true behavior of bellow. The assumptions usually consist of an idealized bellow configuration, a uniform thickness, a homogeneous and isotropic material, and elastic behavior. These assumptions are not precisely correct because we are assuming that the material is uniform thickness, but in practical, if you see, there is some difference of the in microns we will see the difference of the thickness. There is some inhomogeneous material or material elastic behavior is different. So that parameters we are considering in analysis as theoretical, but practical is different. So somewhat assumptions are not precisely correct. The major stresses in bellows results from the effect of pressure and deflection. Normally deflection stresses are higher than the pressure stresses, are generally above yield point of the bellow material and are longitudinal in direction. Pressure produces circumferential hoop membrane stress in the bellow tangent and convolutions. Both longitudinal and bending stresses are produced in the convolutions by pressure. The fatigue life expectancy can be defined as the total number of completed cycles which can be expected from the expansion joint based on data tabulated from the test performed at room temperature under simulated operating conditions. A cycle is defined as one complete movement from initial position in the piping system to the operating position and back to the initial position. This is a typical cycle of the bellows, and this is recommended by the these manufacturers, that bellow life cycles are mentioned in their data sheet. In piping system containing expansion joint, it is frequently impracticable to use main anchor to absorb the pressure thrust or to transmit this force to the connected equipment. In such cases, the proper use of tied hinged or gimbal expansion joint can solve the problem. This is the standard specification or data sheet of the bellow we have to refer, or this is given as per this HMA standards. So in that we have to mention all the details, or we can refer the specification sheet from the manufacturer. So here the tag number is mentioned, quantity, size, then end connections, pressure, design operating, like temperature also mentioned, which media is there, flow velocity of media, flow direction of media, various types of movement, how much distance, how much is the axial extension, axial compression of that bellows. That details like data sheet or product catalog, it is mentioned in this specification sheet. This is one sheet I have referred from this one vendor, manufacturers of expansion joints. So they have mentioned all the details here, so we can refer that details also. Thank you for patience listening. Do like and subscribe my channel for give me some inspiration for making the new topics. Thank you for patience listening. Thanks all.